Hi and welcome back to GM Details. Part 2 of this Jaguar XF R Sport Edition. Now to recap, we've cleaned the wheels, cleaned the tyres, used Garage Therapy Zero Decon Shampoo as a snow foam to give it that good clean decontamination wash, and we've removed what little bonded contaminants that there was on the car. Now it's normally at this time we would consider using a clay bar on the car to get the paintwork really smooth. Well, the paintwork is already smooth, so it's not necessary. We're going to go straight in and use MONSTERSHINE Gloss Lock. Now what is this? It's not a polish, it's a glaze. It's similar to a polish in consistency, as you can see, and I'm applying it using a machine to polish, but it's not. It doesn't have any abrasives in it. That's the main difference between a polish and a glaze. So this is more of a chemical cleanser. It's almost like a pre-wax cleanser, but it's not. It's a different thing altogether. It's a glaze. Yes, you put it on before you put wax on, and yes, it will cleanse the paint, but it also contains a resin filler. Now the resin fillers are designed to go into the scratches that you have on your clear coat of the car and fill them slightly so that it deflects the sunlight, making it look better than it is. That's it in a nutshell. It's smoke and mirrors, if you like, as a really crude analogy. But it's used very heavily in the car trade. Chances are, if you've bought a second-hand car from a dealer, it will have had a glaze on it rather than a polish, because the machine polish takes time. Time is money, and the money sometimes isn't in the profit of the used cars. So they use a glaze. It's quicker, it's easier, the car looks better, and it can be turned around for more profit. So you can use that to your advantage as well. So if you have a car that you think, oh, that, you know, that's awful swirled and scratched, oh, look at it in the sunlight, it's absolutely shocking, it needs a polish, you're considering whether or not to part exchange the car for something new because you don't like the look of it. You say it's a black car and it's lost a little bit of its shine due to the fact it has got swirls and scratches in it, so therefore it looks a bit dull. You could use a glaze and it would actually regenerate it quite well. It would really give it some luster back, some shine. So Gloss Lock is actually really good for that. I'm going to pop a link just in a little card at the top of the screen on the right hand side, and that'll link you to the review that I did, a more intensive review on Gloss Lock. So the ultimate package that MONSTERSHINE sell is this ultimate shine package here. You have Gloss Lock Sealer Glaze to go underneath the Dominator Hybrid Wax, which you would then top with the Hybrid Detailer, and that would just give you an epic up to 10 to 12 months protection from that. So if you wanted to go ahead and do some sort of glaze work on your car, seal it in. Well, the Gloss Lock is going to seal it in anyway, but you know, as it stands on its own, it won't give you that long a protection on its own. Topping it off with the Hybrid Wax and then topping that off again with the Hybrid Quick Detailer once a month in your wash stage, your car will look stunning for up to a year. So it's well worth the investment. I think it's about £35, I think, for the three products there, but really well worth those products. It's worth taking a look at. So why am I applying a glaze with a machine polisher, you might be asking? Well, it's quicker for a start, it gives a better finish, and it gives a more even coat to the paintwork with using a machine. All you're really doing is, on a slow speed, just work the glaze over. As you can see, there's a slight overlap. So you just come by, just overlap the pad, if you don't get your cable caught around your neck. And all you're really doing is just working in the glaze, crossing it over the panel, and wipe off is just super easy. Now that's been curing on the rear doors there for a good 10 minutes. It's super easy to come off and leaves the paintwork very, very slick indeed. Now if you wanted to, you could leave that as it was. Because it's glazed, it's sealed, but as I say, your protection would be diminished. So you're always better off, even if you wanted to. What I'm going to do with this car is I'm going to have the gloss lock and then leave it for a couple of hours to cure and let the sealant do its thing, and then use the hybrid quick detailer over the top of that. I'm only going to use the dominator wax on the black plastics on the car. Use a wax on plastics? Are you mad? Dominator is such a good wax. It's been designed to use anywhere throughout the car. So even on those black plastic, like the wheel arch, the bits that go around your wheel arch, the back of some cars, the front grills on many cars have plastic areas, and you can use that Dominator wax on those. It really is a very, very good wax to use with no white residue, or you don't even need to buff off if you're using it in the plastics either. It's really good. So I'm going to show you now the effect of using a dual action machine polisher, and you'll see how fine and nice an even coat that it's made with the overlapping passes that you've made with the polisher, and it just buffs off with a microfiber cloth so easy to reveal a fantastic shine and gloss as well. And slickness, you can see how the cloth's behaving there, it's just gliding across the panel. So how many of you spotted the severe swirls and scratches on the bonnet of the car a minute ago? Just as I panned across the bonnet, you could see that it was horrific, and that's without an exaggeration. It's horrific. The whole car is covered in swirls and scratches in direct sunlight or under LED lighting. The owner of the car, it's a company car, so why is he wanting to pay for a full machine polishing correction? It doesn't. He just wants it to look as best as it can. So that's my job, to make it look as best as it can. So a glaze and a sealant on top of that is the order of the day. So here we see the sort of comparison, 50-50. This section in the middle here hasn't been touched with the polisher. So you can see how bad the swirls are. Move over to the right hand side, and that's by using the gloss lock. It's a vast improvement, and it's just within the budget for what the customer is expecting to pay. So let's just see if I can make this bonnet look any better. Right, so now gloss lock has been applied. We're going to leave that just to cure for a couple of hours before we apply anything else on top. Into the interior now. Now, leather seats. There's even a leather tag on the back of one of the seats to let you know it is leather. So we're going to use the Leather Repair Company LRC1 cleaner. Now the cleaner will give the leather a deep clean, and again, I'll leave a link up the top to a review that I've done on the leather cleaner. And it's the new Formula One, which has increased cleaning power, and it also foams up beautifully as well. So let's just go on and see how we got on with this. Thank you. studies have shown that steering wheels can harbour all kinds of bacteria, even up to 10 times worse than the germs that are found on public toilet seats. Doesn't bear thinking about. You can see there, there's grease on the leather steering wheel. Has to come off safely. How do we do that? Well, we use leather cleaner again, the same one we used on the seats, LRC1, with a soft horsehair brush. I'll just show you how to do that here. So I always start first of all by putting a microfiber towel actually over the dash. It's not that you don't want the cleaner going over the dashboard itself, but it's just less to clean up and it keeps your work area cleaner and tidier. So spray some of the LRC1 onto the steering wheel, some onto the brush, and just gently work it in. Now I've seen some really bad techniques of cleaning steering wheels and people using all-purpose cleaners with those white melamine sponges, which are absolutely shocking on leather. Yes, they clean it up very well and very quickly, and yes, they turn it round to the side to show you that it's removed, you know, dirt. It's also removing the coating that's on the leather to help protect the leather underneath that coating. You then have this sort of stickiness of the steering wheel, where you've actually removed that top coat protection and then you're into the painted layer of the leather. And the more you think it's stickier, the more you think it still needs cleaner, the more you're removing with this white magic eraser. And what you're actually doing then is removing the colour of the steering wheel. And before you know it, the steering wheel needs complete restoration. So save yourself that time and hassle, and don't use any magic sponges on any leather interior on your vehicle whatsoever. Now I apologise for the overly bright picture there, for you can't see the grime coming off onto the terry cloth there. But it is grimy, you know, obviously you could see the grease on the steering wheel, which is easily removed just by using the gentle horsehair brush. I'm not quite sure about using the, you know, the hog's hair brushes on leather. I would go for something a little bit softer than that. And if you don't have a brush to hand, you can always use a terry cloth with some cleaner on it and just sort of gently work it in with the steering wheel. That will always be better, but absolutely stay away from these all-purpose cleaners with white magic erasers. If you're interested in one of these brushes, they're available from Leather Repair Company or County Detail and Supplies. Now you may not always get all of the grime and dirt off on your first pass, and it's always advisable that if you're still getting some muck on your towel, dirt and grease, if it doesn't come off with the first go of the cleaner, then go again. Two or three times is perfectly normal if you haven't cleaned your steering wheel in months. There's going to be a lot of build up there, so just again, don't go at it too vigorously, don't rub in the same area for too long. So we'll just dry off the final bits of the residue that's left on the steering wheel, and I'll just bring you in just to see how well it's cleaned. Remember that greasy bit that was on it before? Gone. That's what you want. And you can see there how sort of matte the finish is now, rather than greasy, shiny. Because as we all know, greasy, shiny leather is dirty leather. Perfect. Back to the outside now, and for the rear bumper, the lower plastic area, we're going to use MONSTERSHINE Dominator hybrid wax, simply because it's a wax that you can use for your plastics. It's a hybrid wax, so it has SiO2 technology in it, so therefore the wax is going to last extremely long time and be quite durable, especially on the rear of the car when there's going to be a lot of salt being kicked up onto the plastic area there. So the best wax or trim dressing, if you like, for this particular job. Thank you. So if you were wondering what the gloss lock looked like, this is it after it's cured after a couple of hours. It just gives you that machine polished look. Now it's not perfect, obviously there's still those swirls and scratches there, but they're just glazed over. There's some quite a lot of dust on that for this shot as well. With being a black car, shows up quite a lot of dust, but vast improvement, isn't it? And it's just what the customer was looking for. Now what a difference these exhaust tips are. I used some grade 40 steel wool and some metal polish, autosol metal polish on these, and they've come up absolutely a treat. They just look very, very good, and I'm just about to give them a spray of IPA. It just helps to remove any polish residue that's still on the exhaust tips, and then we'll give them a coat of wax. It's a high temperature wax, able to withstand the heat from the exhaust tips. Now the curing time is weather dependent, but as long as you do the swipe test, put your finger on the wax and move your finger across it, if the wax comes off cleanly, it's ready to buff off. If it still smears, it's not ready to buff off, leave it for another 5 minutes. As you can see, the wax is easily buffed off and leaves a fantastic high shine and a good level of protection against heat, salt, any winter condition that you throw at it, hopefully for a good couple of months. Back to the interior again, and I want to include these brushes here from Amplified Detailing. You get four brushes in the set, and they are absolutely the softest, ultra softest brushes that you've ever used. So if you've previously raided your mum's or your wife's or your girlfriend's or your sister's makeup kit for the brushes for using interior, you need to do no more. These are available from Amplified Detailing. You get four in the set, and they're absolutely fantastic for around these infotainment systems, around the buttons, and they're so safe. You get no scratching or marring off them whatsoever. They're incredibly soft. You can use them wet, you can use them dry, you can use them with products as well, and just give them a rinse out once you're finished and they will last for years. Fantastic product from Amplified Detailing there. So the final wipe down here, and I'm going over the car with MONSTERSHINE Hybrid Detailer. It's an SiO2 infused detailer which just gives months of added protection on top of the already gloss lock that's been applied. So the gloss lock had time to cure, and obviously with the hybrid detailer going on top, you're going to get an added boost of gloss and added boost of protection from the SiO2. Couple of sprays is all you need per panel, and just it flashes off very, very quickly. It's a very easy product to use. It doesn't have any scent. Now this is particularly good in the summertime. Now if you're using a quick detailer and it smells sweet, this is actually what attracts the wasps. So if you don't like insects coming around about you, or you're scared of wasps, something like this would certainly be a bonus to you. The cloths that I'm using are a closed loop short pile 320 GSM microfiber cloths called the Perler. You can get these from County Detailing Supplies, and I find them absolutely excellent for applying products like these, and for removal of waxes and sealants too. I think I've over applied the product on the bonnet here, but it's no problem for the Perler. It's managing to remove, buff off, and the rest of it just flashes off no problem. So here we have the final results, ready to hand back to the customer. Full winter prep done, cleansed with garage therapy and protected with MONSTERSHINE. The reason why I didn't protect it with garage therapy is I didn't have the protection products available at the time of recording. I hope you've enjoyed this two-part episode on how to winter prepare your car. I hope it's given you some insight into how you would prepare your own car for winter, or indeed just the same process for preparing it for the summer. I've put all the links of all the products that have been used in the description below. If you have any questions on the detail or you want to ask me about anything, put the questions in the comments and I will answer you. So if this type of video is what you'd like to see more of, let me know in the comments as well and I'll make more of these. Other than that, please do consider subscribing to the channel and turn on the notifications so that you know when a new video has been uploaded. So once again, thank you very much for watching. Thanks very much for sticking with us for these two parts. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you haven't enjoyed it, let me know. Let me know in the comments. So I'll just leave you with the final shots on how beautiful this car is now looking for the customer. I'm sure he's going to be absolutely thrilled with it. I hope you all stay safe. I hope you're all well. And I'll see you on the next video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.